at that point, you know, let me ask you this, you know, a lot of people, if they do reach that pinnacle of career success or, you know, in whatever career they have, many of them lose whatever humility they once ever had, and they believe their own press, that they are the answer to everything, that they are sort of their, you know, in the business world. I mean, Simon and I encountered all the time that people believe in a way that they are their title, right? They are what they do. But when you reach that level of CEO of a public company, you've rang the bell at the New York Stock Exchange, that abrupt fall from that stature to now you're a convicted felon. Now you have no job. Now you've let everybody down, and now you're going to prison. What do you take from that? Was there a point when you were defensive, or did you accept what you'd done and you're like, I need to change?
Yeah, I mean, wouldn't it have been something else if I had become defensive and in denial? And well, you're absolutely right about the pride and the ego, because that can consume you. And what does that do? It creates blind spots, right? And the blind spots are things you don't see, you don't understand. In some cases, you may not have the ability to understand because you don't have those skills, you don't have those experiences. And that's what had happened to me. Partly is I was believing my own press. I was taught how to spin by a public relations firm. I could literally walk circles around most Wall Street analysts. I was told, you know more than they do, and don't ever forget that. And so it, instead of becoming humble, which is what I should have done, I became prideful and egotistical. But that day in front of the judge brought me to my knees and brought me to a level of humility that I had not experienced in decades. Because remember, my rise was pretty exponential, and very little humility involved in that entire process. But to me, there are three characteristics of leaders that are most important. Humility is number one. Number two is integrity. And number three is accountability, because we're all going to make mistakes. We just need to understand how to deal with the mistakes. No, nobody's perfect. No human being's perfect. We're imperfect. And so how you deal with mistakes is just as important as trying to prevent them, because you're not going to be able to prevent all of them. Humility helps because it allows you to listen to others. And as a CEO and a leader, if you haven't learned the art of listening to the right people, by the way, because you could surround yourself with people who are giving you the bad advice. And so, by the way, as part of my stay in prison, and I served 3.5 years of the 48 months, I developed a sense, because I spoke to all kinds of people while in prison. I took a road trip as a guest of the Bureau of Prisons, moving from prison to prison until I ended up back at the Miami camp. And I got to talk to hundreds and hundreds of fellow inmates, some of which were ex-CEOs, ex-CFOs, attorneys, doctors, politicians, bank robbers, drug dealers, you know, head of a biker gang. And I got to ask them, you know, how they made decisions and why they were in prison. A lot of them were still in denial. I didn't break any laws. The government set me up, this and that. But when you work through that facade and you started to get to the real reasons that had put them there, it was blinding flash of the obvious, bad decisions. How did they make those decisions? Most of them did not have a framework by which to make decisions that would allow them to stay away from the bad ones, identify them, stay away from them, and then only stay with the alternatives that had been good out, that would have been resulted in good outcomes. No guarantee, but at least a fighting chance that you're making the right decision.